We have the second example of recursive method. So we have the following example that says, in the main method, we will have only one statement. It says print line, some digits 34. Some digit is the name of the method, and this is the method some digit. It will take an integer n and it will return an integer. So here we expect that we will take a number and we will return a number. We have if n less than or equal to 0, we have to return 0. Else we have to return n modulus 10 plus some digits n over 10. So the base case, if you reach 0, this is the end and you have to return 0. Otherwise, you have to return n modulus 10 plus. You need to call the method and you need to change the value of n. You have to divide n by 10. So we will start with the example from the main and we need to find the output. So we expect only one number to be displayed at the end. So here we will start from the main method. I have to find what is the result of calling the method some digit such that I will send the number as 34. Calling the method for the first time, it means the value of n here will be as 34. Now we have to check the condition. If n is less than 0, it's not. I will have to go to the else part. In the else part, it says we have to do the following. We have to return n modulus 10 a plus. Again, I have to call the method some digits and I have to send n over 10. So currently the value of n is 34. So when we say 34 modulus 10, the meaning of modulus is remainder. So 34 modulus 10, we will have the value as 4. 4 plus, call the method and you have to send n over 10. The current value of n is 34, so we have 34 over 10. When we divide integer over integer, we will get an integer, so we will have the number as 3. So here I will have to call the method and I will send the value 3. So I have to return 4 plus the name of the method and I have to send the value 3. So here we have a 3. And we will call the method again, and this will be the second call. And here, the value of n, we should have it as a 3. Is the value of n less than or equal to 0? It's not. Then I have to go to the else. And the else, again, I have to say return the value of n modulus 10. The value of n currently is a 3. The 3 modulus 10, this will give us the result as a 3. So we will have here, we will have the result as 3. A plus, call the method and you have to send n over 10. The value of n currently is a 3. 3 over 10, integer over integer will be an integer, so it's more like saying I have to call the method and I have to send 0. So I have to say 3 plus, call the method and send 0 as the new value. So we will call our method, this will be the third one, and the value of n will be 0. Start from the method n equals 0, and here if I have the if n is less than or equal to 0, we have to return 0. So here we have to stop, and we have to say return 0. Now return 0, this is the base case, this is the end. So we have to go back, and we have to do the calculation once we go back. Return 0 from call number 3 to the previous call. So 3 will be coming there, which means the result of this calling as 0. So 3 plus 0 now, I have to take it to the previous call. So this will be as having 3. 3 plus 4 is 7, so we will go to the main, and the result of the calling as is 7. Now, once we go to the main, we need to output what is the value of the method. So we will have the output as 7. So we have only one number, which is the output. So the idea behind this this example is you will take a number and then you will just go from the number 34 to 3 till you reach 0. When you go back, then you have to do the summation of their digits. So the idea is happening more like we divide the number till we reach 0. So if we will think about it, we can say if I have the value of n as 34, I need to count the digits and then take the summation of these digits. So what we will say, we'll say I have to take this 4 and I will keep it there, and I will say plus, and I need to call my method such that n should get rid of 4. How can we get rid of the 4? By dividing by 10, and that's why we say here n over 10. So the next time you call your method, if you divide 34 over 10, it will be as a 3. Here you have a 3, so you will have to take a 3 plus, and then you will go to the third call, and again you need to divide the 3 over 10, and it will give you as 0. And then you go back and you say 3 plus 0 plus 3 plus 4, and that's why you get the result as 7. To get this number, which is the digit 4, the digit 3, you will have to say n modulus 10. To go from a number till you reach 0, always you have to divide by 10. So each time you will get rid of one digit. So here the idea is, the base case, if I reach 0, I will return 0, and this is the end. Otherwise, each time I will take only one digit, the right digit. And to take the right digit, I have to say n modulus 10. And I need to continue, and because I need to continue, it means I have to call my method, but I have to change the value of n. To change the value of n, I have to divide it by 10. This example can be modified, for example, to do other things. So for example, if the question was saying you need to do not the summation of digits, actually you need to do the multiplication of digits. So if you have, for example, your n as 34, you need to multiply 3 by 4, so you need to get the result as 12. Now, because I need here to do multiplication, the small thing I have to start with is, instead of saying a plus here, we will say multiplication. So I will just change it to multiplication. Always I need to take the digits, digit 3, digit 4, and so on. So we will use the same thing, n modulus 10. This is, will not be changed. Always I have to keep calling my method, so I will use some digits. And always I have to change n, so I will have to use n over 10. So within the general case, the only thing I have to change is multiplication instead of a plus. The second small change I have to do is I have to play with the base case. If we do the summation, just like in this case, we say return 0 because we have a pluses in between. Here, if we need to do multiplication, and instead of saying return 0, I have to say return 1, because I need to say 3 multiplied by 4. If you keep it at 0, it means the result will be 0. So here I just have to change the base case to be 1, so the result will be as 12, which is the result we are looking for. So if you need to change this example from a plus to multiplication, only you have to do the multiplication and you have to change the base case. And in most examples, when we deal with numbers, in most cases we use n over 10, because each time we will get rid of one digit. So we can do the counting of digits, we can do the summation of digits, we can do, for example, do how many even, how many odd digits we have.